Are you having a crappy week? Actually, you don't have to tell me. I know you're having a crappy week. There was just a recent study about cybersecurity professionals. Basically said you guys are all exhausted, overtired, because you're overworked because of the workforce shortage. Well, I got good news for you. Your week just got a whole lot better. Because of CyberVista, we're introducing a new weekly video series called Questions That Need Answers. You know we love our acronym, so QTNA. And we're going to be going over some of the most important cybersecurity concepts, both for certification exams and for your experience in the real world. And today's question that needs an answer is... I think I spelled that wrong. There's no spell check on the light board, so it's really not my fault. An encrypted email has been sent. With what does the sender encrypt the message? All right. So let's just sort of recap the question here. All they're saying is we have an email and we need to encrypt that email. We want to send it to somebody and have that same email be decrypted and read by the other party. All right, in order to get this question right, you have to understand asymmetric cryptography. And remember, that's the system where everybody has two keys, a public key and a private key. And these two keys are mathematically related in such a way where one encrypts and the other decrypts, and vice versa. They are fated together, like Romeo and Juliet. They're made for each other. So let's look at how this actually plays out. Say we have two communicating parties. We have Jordan, and they want to send an encrypted email to their friend Michael. So if Jordan wants to send an email to Michael that is encrypted and nobody else in the entire world except for Michael can read that email, watch what happens. Jordan is going to encrypt the email with Michael's public key. Why does this matter? Right, because if one encrypts, the other has to decrypt. So if we're going to encrypt with Michael's public key, we know that the only thing that could decrypt that email is Michael's what? Private key, exactly. And who in the world is the only person who has Michael's private key? That's right, Michael. So the answer is A, recipient's public key, because the sender is always going to encrypt with the recipient's public key. And remember, if you're feeling confident and you feel like you have a good grasp on asymmetric cryptography, just remember you actually don't really understand it, right? There's only 10 people in the world who actually understand cryptography. But luckily for us, coming from a certification exam perspective, we're not gonna have to go too deep into the weeds with cryptography. So again, I hope you learned something. I hope this was helpful. Hope to see you in class, and we'll see you next week on QTNA.